Hello, I'm Chris, your host, narrator, and operator for all do-it-yourself projects right here on ATL Solar Trek and Atlantic Drain. All right, I'm going to do a final test for power to the well pump, and all the power is coming from the Big Red Solar Pavilion, all solar powered workshop. And I'm going to turn the water on, release the pressure in the tank. The pump should kick on, and I'm going to turn the water off and refill the tank, repressurize the system. Pump's on. Turn that water off. Bringing water from the well into the tank. And we're getting it pressurized. Should shut off there about 50 psi. Perfect. And again, this system, it's 115 volts AC, 6.6 amps of current being drawn.
That's about 800 watts of power.
For DC power, that's going to be running up there about 65 amps. Drawn continuously as long as that pump is on. And I think the first thing I want to do is wash that solar roof on the Big Red Solar Pavilion. We're going to go ahead and give a freshwater wash down to the solar pavilion using our shallow well pump. And that's right, it's solar powered. And we're going to wash down all the solar panels as well. We have 8 of them out here today. 3 permanently fixed, a couple that are on the Big Red power station, and then 3 portable arrays which I set around when it's sunny out. Before starting this video series on gathering, storing, and consumption of solar energy, I thought a lot about showing the viewer different tasks or demands that are on a solar powered storage system. Currently, the maximum power output from the Big Red power station is 2,750 watts. So let's break down that total power. 2,000 watts comes from a 2,000 watt inverter, and 750 watts is assigned to a 750 watt inverter. So adding those two inverter outputs together gives us our maximum power output of 2,750 watts. Today's power demo is the shallow well pump. We'll be using the 2,000 watt inverter, and we shall be monitoring maximum power draw and continuous sustained power draw. This will be shown on the inverter's LED display, which will in turn allow us to calculate the stored energy used in our battery banks. Wow, that looks so much better. So, 900 watts, if you divide that by 12, that comes out to about 75 amps. Of DC current that is needed continuously to run that pump. So we'll break that down even further. 75 amps are needed to run the inverter and the shallow well pump. Well, it runs continuously for about 10, maybe 15 minutes of that 75 amp hours. So let's just say we've got 75 amps times 1/4. That would be about 15 minutes of an hour. that comes out to about 18.6 amps of current that are needed to run that for 15 minutes. All right, so we understand that portion of it. Let's see if we can get to where it's the amount of power that is used. That would be 18.6 times, I'm going to use a reference voltage of 12 volts. So 18.6 times 12 equals about 223 watts. That's a good amount of current, but no problem for the solar pavilion to recharge it. This thing's capable of 800 watts per hour on a good sunny day. Thank you for watching all of our do-it-yourself projects and more. Remember, it's easy once you know how.